Welcome back, Real Heels fans. Glad to have you. Wednesday morning, big day for us.
Rivalry game.
Rivalry game tonight with the NC State Wolfpack. We would like to put out just a small disclaimer for those of you maybe who have left some naughty language on YouTube in regards to our show. We thank you.
Yes.
And if you take it that seriously, well, then you may be missing the whole point of the show.
Yes, you may be missing the point of the show, and maybe you should spend a little more time just worrying about your own programs and the problems that they have.
Maybe get your own show. I don't know.
And thanks for your support.
Just means you're watching. Today, we're very happy to introduce a new segment on our show. It's called the Coach's Corner. It's an in-depth look at how we run various offensive plays throughout the season.
Today, for the first segment of Coach's Corner, we're going to outline and diagram the high pick and roll.
Should be exciting. Let's take a look.
All right, Real Heels fans. We're here, late in the game, down by one. We're going to show you how to execute the high pick and roll.
We're getting ready to score two. Real quick points. Maybe if we get fouled, Tyler Hansbrough, three.
Three!
I'm the primary ball handler and soon-to-be scorer on this play. Comes my wingman, Steven.
I go ahead. I immediately recognize the 2-3 defense sitting at the table across from us, and I notice they're making a beeline to the bar. Soon as I see them make that trip to the bar, I immediately cross half court and confront the 2-3 zone defense by setting a high screen before they get to the bar area.
As I notice Bond setting the high screen, I dribble around, wait for Patron to slide out, and then behind the high screen, slide up to the bar. Bingo bango, vodka tonic for two, and I'm beside a hot chick.
That's a three.
Every day of the week.
Boom. See how easy that was? In and out, fresh vodka tonic in hand.
Easy and delicious.
We need to be prepared tonight for a fight. This is an important game. Now that Duke has lost to Wake Forest, we have a shot to get a share of the ACC title.
If any team that gets embarrassed the way that they did coming to play at our place, you know that they're going to defend their court and they are going to come out with a whole different attitude. And we're not trying to make excuses before the game starts. We'll make note that the injury bug has bitten us pretty hard in the old Tookus.
Well, we've had the flu, Thompson's knee, Lawson's still not going to play. Marcus Ginyard has an ankle and a toe problem, I think. Tyler has a toe problem. We've been snake bitten.
I can tell you one thing. If Mark Davis finds a way to make this team healthy before the year's up, he is in line for a Woody.
The guy is in line for a Woody.
I bet he never saw that coming.
No, I bet he did see that coming. I didn't even see that coming. That being said, we're looking forward to and hoping for Carolina victory. But before that victory, as always, we need to get the keys to the game with Jed Drake.
Good to be back on with the Real Heels. Got the keys to the game, and today the keys to the game are brought to you by the Dollhouse. That's where the UNC team likes to relax after a big win in Raleigh. Jumping into the keys to the game, number one, we need to defend the three-pointer better. We hadn't done it all year. I've got a bad feeling about this NC State team throwing up some prayers and making them. Number two, this is what I'm going to call weather the storm. This is NC State's national championship game. They're going to be pumped up. They're going to come out of the gates like crazy. The crowd's going to be way into it. I even have a sense that they may even jump out to an early lead. We need to weather the storm, play our game, and we'll come out on top. I think we'll be victorious in Raleigh. Go Heels.
There are schools that will go unnamed that have certain beliefs about UNC, but we're going to tell you if it's fact or fiction. A lot of people like to call Carolina the wine and cheese crowd.
Yeah.
I would have to say that that's possibly a fact.
Could be. I know I enjoy a nice, delicious glass of wine.
Who doesn't like wine? It gets you drunk.
Love wine.
You know, when it comes to cheese, this is a little 2% white American craft sliced cheese.
This is great.
Who doesn't? We like all kinds of cheese.
Delicious.
We like all kinds of wine.
Pepper Jack, Swiss.
We like beer. We like booze. You know we like vodka tonics.
Yeah. So, yeah, fact.
Fact. And, you know, you're missing out if you don't like it.
Yeah. There's also innuendo that those of us who attended UNC and UNC's fans are arrogant. Well, if by arrogant you mean perfect,
then yes.
Yeah, got us again.
What's wrong with that? Yeah. Academically gifted, yes. Athletically gifted, yes.
Why don't you read us off a couple of facts here?
How about 5 men's basketball national championships?
9 consensus player of the year honors.
16 Final Fours.
Overall record of 1,914 wins and only 696 losses. for a winning percentage of 733, second only to Kentucky, and we're closing in.
So why are we arrogant? The numbers speak for themselves. There's another thing that people like to complain about. They like to say that Carolina gets all the calls. Well, I have news for you. That is not true. First of all, most of the refs in the ACC are not very good at calling anything. And that's not our fault. Secondly, 696 times calls didn't go our way.
Yeah. Hell, if those officials had done their job and we'd gotten the calls,
we would have won.
Yeah, we'd be undefeated. Check the stat book. Do the math. You do the math.
Come on, that's common sense, people. It's ridiculous.
It's also a little myth that ABC stands for anybody but Carolina.
Doesn't.
Gotta be honest with you. No, it doesn't.
Doesn't.
It's really just three letters of the alphabet. ABC could stand for alcoholic beverage control. I do know that's a fact.
Could stand for alcoholic beverage consumption. Carolina fans claim that God was a Tar Heel. Well, let's be honest. We don't really know if God really was a Tar Heel. It's possible because he's awesome.
I never met him, but seems pretty cool.
The fact that he's awesome means that there's a good likelihood he's a Tar Heel. Next time you look up to heaven, you tell me what color the sky is.
It's making a pretty strong case. Tough to argue.
Again, all these things point that God might be a Tar Heel, but we're not sure.
Right. We're just going to leave a big question mark with that.
Yeah.
Well, it's game time. We're going to go inside, check the game out. And you know what? I believe we've proved that we've got some character. This team's got a little character, and I like that.
Well, we got a lot of character. You know what else we have a lot of?
Tyler Hansbrough.
For his defense, lost Hansbrough. Hansbrough gets the bucket and a foul.